science is aspirational, and science is not going to be put off by the dissuasive pessimism of philosophers. It's going to go down its own route with the philosophers and the theologians tagging along in our wake.
Philosophers, in my experience, aren't always so pessimistic. I think all that philosophers ask of scientists is that they respect or understand a little bit the nature of the game that they're playing, which you do quite clearly, and in Conjuring the Universe, it's quite clear where you draw the lines, the demarcation between what is scientific and what is metaphysical, perhaps in the nature of the speculation that is often needed when we think these big thoughts. Do you have any anticipation at this stage, given where we are with structures like the Large Hadron Collider and the various really exciting projects to explore the nature and structure and evolution of the universe that are currently planned, like the James Webb Telescope? Do you have any sense for whether some of the answers to the bigger, deeper questions will come, let's say, in a reasonable lifetime? Or is this something that will be forever around the corner or forever just beyond grasp?
How pessimistic that view would be, to think that everything was running just a little bit faster than we are.
Yes.
I think, look at the progress that science, not just physics, but science in general, has made in the 300 years that it's been taken seriously, and marvel at the capacity of the human brain to unravel the fabric of the universe. Well, the problems are getting more and more difficult, so we should not expect quick fixes. But our ability to share and collaborate is increasing. CERN, for example, look at the collaboration that goes into discovering the Higgs particle. I mean, it's quite extraordinary, yet it was achieved. And I think as if human brains conspire together, then there is every hope, I can put it no further than that, that we will arrive at a deep and final understanding of the nature of physical reality. Maybe finding that in the end it was just algebra anyway.
And indeed adds up to nothing.
And indeed adds up to nothing. I think that would be wonderful. I think science will have achieved its ultimate goal, having gone through swinging pendulums, titrations, natural selection, general relativity, if it can show that at the end of the day, really there's nothing here at all. Wouldn't that be wonderful?